supposed to be up to what it was last year. So I was thinking about bowel cancer and wondering, well, who really gives a shit? I mean, how many people die of this anyway? And like the TV says, you know, we're all dying like flies on the road. So I had a look at death statistics. So here's the road trauma deaths, and they're reasonably recent. It says in 2014, 1,156 people died on our roads, and 34,000 people were hospitalised. Now I should point out that the death rate is 5 per 100,000 of the population. And this, incidentally, is the lowest number ever. And why, might you ask? Because some people have taken an awful lot of time and money to make it so. When you look at the colorectal cancer numbers, I'll keep those flashing for you, okay? You can see that in terms of hospital stays, colorectal cancer is about half of what we do with road traffic accidents. That's good. But then you look at the number of deaths. And there are over 4,000 deaths from colorectal cancer. That's not 5 per 100,000 of the population. That's 15 per 100,000 of the population. Let that sink in. All right? All the hoo-ha about road deaths, and four times more people are dying from colorectal cancer. Oh my God, says the politicians and the populace. Something has to be done about this. And I agree. We should be seeing headlines like this. This is a national disgrace. And so I was thinking, after Ruth asked me to do a talk, well, what the hell am I going to talk about? And then, as so often happens, circumstances come about. And I was driving home one day, and then I was thinking about what am I going to do, and then all of a sudden, this is what happened. And I thought to myself, shit, police! And as though you know me, my brain works in a particular way. I then got a bright idea. I might say the solution was staring at me with its one eye. And the idea was, police! The road toll is smaller. We don't need that many police anymore for that. What we need is police. Okay? And let's face it, retraining police will be very easy. Because after all, they already conduct random breath testing. So why don't we have random poo testing? They already have cops. They already have a good rapport with all the people in their corporation. They're up with all the latest gadgets. And they already shout, assume the position. Not only that, but they have a lot of community initiatives which we can retask. We have crime stops. We could do something with that. Stopping the guy next door that hasn't had his colonoscopy. Some of the signs would only take a little bit of alteration. But you know, there would be problems if you'd have to retrain people, because some people would get it wrong. And one of the things you would have to be worried about, of course, is people that want to get a second opinion while they're on the spot. I think, though, that if you're going to do that, and you're going to split the police into these two groups, you need to have a new uniform. And so here I'd like you to introduce you to the New South Wales Police. Here he is. PC Smith, the long finger of the law. Now, what's been going on in the background has been that if you look at this, the incidence and the mortality graphs, you will see that we doctors have actually been able already to reduce mortality of colorectal cancer by half. So the 4,000 people that exist already have been because of a massive effort, but there are another 4,000 people that need to not die of colorectal cancer. Okay? That's a 20-year effort. This is good, but it's not good enough. So, today, what is your plan P? Will you get your screening done? Or will we just set the poo lease on you? Thank you very much for the opportunity to talk to you again, and who knows what next year will bring.